Everyone, today I'm going to share how to have the courage to walk alone. See, whatever you want to be, then you should have the courage to walk alone, because if you want to be top actor, top dancer, top bodybuilder, right? Or in fact, top motivational speaker, right? Or top singer, anything, right? Top tarot reader, top makeup artist, top fashion designer. So there will be a lot of people who won't like it. It will include people from your family, it will include people from your friends, and it will include people from your followers, right? So first of all, I want to say that of course everybody won't be a top fashion designer like Manish Malhotra, right? Or everybody won't be a top fashion designer like Sabyasachi, right? And of course Manish Malhotra also might not have friends who are also fashion designer, right? And if you want to be a top makeup artist or top dancer, like if you see Beyonce, or if you truly admire Madhuri Dixit, do you think that Madhuri Dixit have friends who are also Madhuri Dixit? No, right? So of course there won't be people in your social circle who are same. So you should have the courage to walk alone, and top of that, they are going to demotivate you, that why you're doing this, it does not matter, right? So do you think that people who would have told Madhuri Dixit that she cannot be superstar, or Jennifer Lopez, or maybe in fact Hema Malini as well, right? So she is also beautiful and I truly admire her. So do you think they would have been the stars there are right now? So if I talk about Hema Malini or Helen, they did dance in 70s or 80s or maybe in 50s, right? When society had such an orthodox mindset, still they did what they truly wanted to do, right? So do you think that there were not people who tried to stop them, who said crap about them, or who spread false rumor about them? There will be, right? But I think you should not care about those people, and you should focus on mastering your craft, right? And do you think that if I truly admire Tony Robbins, so Tony Robbins, or if even, you know, I truly admire Marie Forleo and Grant Cardone as well, so do you think that, or in fact Jay Shetty as well, do you think that they have not worked on their craft, right? Do you think that they became what they became just like that, right? Of course they worked on their craft, and then they are where they need to be, right? Nobody becomes successful by doing something once a week or once a month. You have to work hard. And I remember Tony Robbins said that when he started his first seminar, only three people shown up, right? So but what if he would have stopped by then, right? So he did not stop, and that's why he is where he is, right? So and that's why, you know, he always inspire everyone. If he would have stopped by then 40 years ago, he would not have been the person he is right now. And right, so the people who truly work on the dream inspire others as well. And the people who don't believe in themselves and don't believe they can do anything in the world, they try to demotivate others as well, because they don't have the confidence that they can go ahead and do that thing, right? Otherwise, I think the person who truly believe in himself or herself will never try to drag you down. Only the person who, you know, is not confident in himself or don't believe that he or she can go ahead and fulfill that dream will try to do that, right? So I think you should not listen to others. Focus on mastering your craft, right? And more you will master your craft, more you are going to shine. Let people say anything, let people spread false rumor, who cares, right? I don't care, and I think you should also not care, right? Also, I want to say that I make content for my ideal client. I don't, because my mentor in 2019 was Marie Forleo, and I truly admire her, and she guided me to make content for people who are my ideal clients. So I know not everyone want to work with me, nor I want to work with anyone, right? So I ask a lot of questions to people who want to work with me, because I want to know if they are right people for me or not, right? So there are a lot of things I check, that you are the right person for me. Money is not everything. So though you all know that how much I charge for coaching, but yeah, but still I want to check, like, if you are the right person or not, right? And if you need my coaching or not, because my coaching is not for everyone. I have clear boundaries that no matter, you know, if you're a billionaire or millionaire, flirting is not allowed in my session. And I'm quite ambitious person, and I'm quite professional person. So, and yes, and I want to work with great people, not with any Tom, Dick and Harry, right? And yeah. So yeah, I have standard in my personal life and in my professional life as well. All right, and if some people don't like it, that's okay. I'm not for you. All right, you can go ahead and search some other coach who is for you. All right, have a wonderful and a blessed day ahead, everyone. Bye bye, take care, guys.